Hello, welcome to another episode of technical session. Welcome to Flamingus Technologies. I hope you are doing well. We at Dubai also are doing very well. Today, I would like to talk about a cloud-based backup recovery solution, which I feel it's one of the simplest available today in the market. The name is Acronis Backup Cloud. It purely runs on the cloud. The key features of this technology is purely for backing up and restoring your files and the entire VMs to the cloud. So we can see some of the options here: local and cloud backup, recovery of any platform, file and disk image backup, physical backup of Windows, Linux, and most of the available backup solutions, whatever it can do, all this can be done by the solution. You can see here, we can backup Windows machines, Linux machines, Mac, virtualization, VMware, Citrix, Hyper-V, Red Hat, Oracle, all of them, Exchange, Active Directory. What are the features? It has got a very simple web-based console wherein from any part of the world you can log in and check your backup. For example, you have multiple branches and you wanted to control the backup from a central location without setting up a costly VPN. We can do this using this console. That is what is web-based cloud console. Remote agent update from the management console. We can push the remote agent from the management console and we can self-service account is available for you. And the entire data is backed up using a very strong AES-256 encryption. And it is a proven solution. Acronis, you all already know that it is, they are masters in the market already for backup. Now that your data is stored in this data center safely and it is secured actually. You can see here, this is the cloud where your data, your entire VMs or your files are sitting. And this backup cloud helps us to manage it. This is sold from Acronis through distributor, through a reseller to you, customer. Now you have your physical servers, virtualization workstation, all that. And the beauty here is you can backup to the cloud or into the local premises very easily. If you take any cloud-based solutions for backup today, for any backup solutions, they normally prefer local backup first, then the cloud backup comes. But here we have cloud first. As you know, we are in the cloud era and we strongly believe that this will help you in reducing your workload. It is purely 100% paper use, prices per GB, there is no complex CPU, there is no complex sockets and all that. It's purely price per GB per month of compressed data. And we have the licensing is hosted per paper use. You know, there is no capex, it's very easy, you already know about this. And we have one more option for hybrid. Means we can have some data here on your premises and also on the cloud. The recap, the backup, for everything, as you can see, you can take backups, all the environments, and we can store to the local disk, USB drive, network share, and the cloud. Recovery, we can recover data, we can recover a bare metal recovery. We will see that in our presentation, how is it going to do. You can do migrations also. Physical to physical, physical to virtual, virtual to virtual, all this possible. Now, let's straight away jump into the demo. As you can see here, right now, we as a company, Flamingus Technologies, we are acting as a service provider for you. And as you can see, it's very easy to become a service provider these days because we are reselling the cloud for you. So that means we are becoming a service provider. For test purpose, we have created a company called Smart Solutions, where Smart Corporation, in using that we will be doing all the backup. Just to show how do we create a new company, we first click on Flamingus Technologies as a parent company, then we create ad group. And we provide details. So as you can see here, the new company is created, and we can provide administrators, you know, your administrators, system admins, we can add an account, we can give them username, password, or the one password is set up. I'm not doing that, but I just want to show you that how easy it is. As a company, the first administrator is created using this, then we can have more administrators created. This is the properties, you know, what all the, you have any quota set up. We have not set up any quota. We can set up any quota also for your requirements. And what are the storage allocated for you? We can see here. And any branding required, we can do that. Security, login control, these are the main things. So now this is the company we have created where we are running the demo. Now in this, there are two accounts. One, this is one administrator. Now this company has, as you can see here, already 18.7 GB is used. And we'll go to the company's properties and show you what are the allocations. For this company, when we set up this company, we did not have any quota. So we are setting a quota for this. We will have two physical workstations, physical servers, two virtual machines, 20 mobile devices, 50. You can even have office 365 mailboxes directly backed up, but we are not doing that. Storage quota, we can, you know, provide you the quota of storage, like in GBs. Let's say I'm giving you 500 GB. The backup locations, we can specify when we provide you the login. We can specify whether we are going to provide you local and cloud or cloud only backup. That means if it is only cloud only backup, you can't save anything on the local premises. Now we are going to actual the client's login page. This is the URL, https://cloud.acronis.com. You just need to go to the URL as a customer, and you are presented with this ID, the username, password, which already you have, because as a service provider, I have created for you, and you use it and login. This you can, as is it on the cloud, you can log in from anywhere without any problems. Now, when you log in first time, you will not find any workloads here. The main console shows like this, the devices, the backups, the activities and alerts and settings. Okay, in the devices, as it says, this is where we add the devices for backup. So in this situation, what you can see here, this is a VM. We have already done a backup. That's why this status is okay. And there is a VMware VM. So that means we have picked it up from VMware. So we will show you how we are getting the devices. We'll click on add. So when you click on add, you will find a very beautiful window, wherein you will find the different agents for Windows, Mac, servers, mobile devices, virtualization host. Now, if you want to take a backup of a Windows, it can be VM or physical, we just need to click on that. So when you click on that, it will take you to a backup agent. The backup agent will be downloaded to your machine, and you just simply take it to the virtual machine or physical machine and run the executable file. When you run the executable file, it will ask you a username password to the cloud which you logged into. So once you logged in, and that is the only thing to be done, the agent's installed. And the moment you put the correct username password where you logged in here, all the information of this machine is automatically registered onto the cloud. You have seen for iOS and same way for Android, there's another app. Now for the VMware Hyper-V and Virtuoso, let's talk about VMware. What happens when we click on VMware? It gives us a small executable file. This file is installed on any of your machines running on the host. Let us say you have two hosts, and each of the host you have to pick up one virtual machine and install the software. Again, you install the software, it asks for the vCenter server or the virtual machine itself, the host itself actually. So it can easily pick up all the virtual machines and display it on the screen. That's what we have done here. What you can see here, we have already configured VMware. We have added our vCenter server. This is our vCenter server, and it picked up all the machines available on the host. We can see here all the VMs, which this VMware symbol is there, all the VMs have already been picked up. So this is, as you can see here, it is a very simple procedure, and without any hassles we get all the information. Now that you have your devices here listed, our next task is to do a backup. All our VMs available here, we will look at the backup options. So before going for backup, we need to decide where we want to backup. The one of the option is obviously the cloud, and also we can specify a network share or a file share. We would like to show you that. Click on backup. Then you can see which is already used. We can see a cloud storage here, and we can see network share. To show how it works, we will just add one new. Just go to browse and pick up a network folder. You can even go for NFS folder. So here we are showing you by adding a new network folder. So we have a file folder already here. Now you can see a new folder. You can select any folder. So for testing here, we are selecting a new folder called Acronis. Once you finish, say done. Now you can see the new folder is created. Okay, now let us go back to the devices. Now we can see all the devices. Now I'm going to show you how to take a backup of a Windows 10 machine to cloud. Just select the machine, check mark, and click on backup. Now the first option I'm going to take, there are two options here. If you click here, enter machine to cloud storage. So what are the details you can see here? So I'm going to say apply. So now what will happen? This Acronis will backup the entire VM to the cloud. It will automatically adjust the bandwidth so that your current network is not affected actually. So you can see here it is checking the availability, and you can say run now. Because it is a first time backup, it will do a full backup into the cloud. It takes a good amount of time. It's going to start now. After some time, when you go to activities, you can see here what is happening. You can see the current situation. You can see here the entire VM is going to the cloud, and the percentage is completed. Let it continue. Now we are going to show you how to take a backup of a VM onto a network. Go to devices. I have a Linux appliance called NS Demo. I'm going to back it up onto the network. Backup, the default option comes as backup to cloud, but we need to create a new plan. In the new plan, we can edit the plan. We have to click on, where to backup, then select the network folder. We can browse the folder. We browse to the location and we select the folder. Now in this case, we are selecting a folder called Acronis on the network. Okay, once it is finished, you just need to click on done. So the backup plan is verified, we can see some settings here, like monthly. We can change all this. All options are available. Replication is, suppose you want to replicate to a different location, that also we can choose. Or else, for now, we'll just say apply. So now this VM which is running here, it will be backed up to a network location. It's saved, and whenever we are ready, please click on run now. So now it starts actual backup process. It picks up the data from the VMware or from the virtual machine, and it puts it onto the network. Status, we go to activities, and we can see that this machine backup is going on. And if you click on show details, we'll get more details in this actually. What exactly is going on. You can see the backup is succeeded. Now we can go to the backups. When you click on the location where we selected from, we can see that this VM, entire VM is backed up actually. The next step, what we are going to show, is to retrieve the entire backup. Let's say now we are going to the recovery process. Okay, so now we want to recover this VM. Click on the show backups. Now there are two options. Because it's a virtual machine, we have two options. One is recover, one is run as VM. Recover means it will overwrite onto the existing virtual machine onto the exact same place. We can see entire machine or file folders. This is a Linux machine, so we can't do that now. So if you say recover entire machine, means it will, just like a normal backup, it will restore. Now we will show as instant recovery. We will click on run as VM. It will create a duplicate virtual machine with the same settings and IP address with a different name onto the hypervisor. So we can click on the virtual machine to be created. So we select ESXi, we can give a machine name. Yeah, this is our host details. We can give a name, new name. So click OK. So this machine will be instantly recovered onto the hypervisor. Options are ready. We click on run now. Now it will automatically try to start the virtual machine on the cloud, on the hypervisor. So now we'll go to the hypervisor screen. See this virtual machine which is running on instant recovery mode. You can, this is the machine running here actually. So we can run this machine as a instant recovery mode without affecting the current VM actually. We also have option for recovery wherein it overrides the virtual machine. Now this virtual machine is backed up onto the cloud. Now I wanted to pick up specific files from the backup. So I'll click on recover, file folders. Now we can see here, these are the drives retrieved from the folders from the virtual machine backup. We click on any of the folder. So as you can see here, let's say we are going to one folder and pick up one file. We click on the file and you can say recover or download. You can say download the file, you can get the files also. Downloadable. So that's how we can retrieve a file from the internet where the entire machine is backed up. Yeah. In the short demo, we try to demonstrate backup and recover the Windows and other machines to the cloud. Also to the on-premise storage. And also how to recover the entire VMs and the files. For more information, please feel free to contact us. Thanks for watching.